Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15 is under 25 days away from being shown for the first time at the Worldwide Developer Conference on June 7th. And so I thought we'd go over some of the things we want to see most with iOS 15. I've talked about what the leaks are and the rumors and the supported devices, but there's a bunch of things you want to see most, and I think some of those will actually be coming to iOS 15. I asked a question on Twitter, what feature do you want Apple to add to iOS 15 the most? There were over 250 responses, and based off that information, I categorized it into what you wanted to see most. Now, the first thing I want to see most actually is under settings and battery. So under battery health, currently it just tells us 100%. I've talked about this before where I personally would like to see them change this to good, bad, or change your battery, or something along those lines where we had maybe a stoplight system. A little less percentage details because this causes a lot of anxiety and I get messaged multiple times every day about this. So, or maybe more clarification for this. I would also like to see under the last 10 days, the last charge. So since the last charge, I want to see how much power I've used. This currently only shows the past 24 hours while charging or not charging. So if you're charging during this, you can actually change these results to be higher than they really are. So I would like to see more clarification on this, a little bit better overview of your actual battery usage. Now, the first thing you wanted to see most had to do with an overall redesign or an overhaul. Back in 2013, we had iOS 7. We haven't seen a redesign since. So we went from iOS 6 to iOS 7, which looked like this. So it reverted to sort of a flat design, and we've had that flat design for about 8 years at this point. So most people want to see a redesign with updated icons and things like that. And again, I'm using Angelo Libero's designs to show you what could be the future of iOS 15 with a redesigned multitasker, maybe clipboard at the bottom, and he allowed me to use these photos. So I really appreciate it. So along with that, many people want to see updated icons. People are sick of the flat icons or maybe just the icons in general. And many people also want to see the home screen in landscape mode. Now, we used to have this on older devices and still do on some of them, but it's only on the Plus model phones. They ended this with the iPhone 8 Plus for the most part, and we haven't had it since with Face ID. So it's something a lot of people want to see more of. Also, many people want to see a close all apps button. So where you would have your apps, tap a button and it would close everything. So that's the first thing, a complete redesign with some changes there. The next thing most people want to see is split screen. And I think we're going to see this. And again, you'll have that close all button here. You would have the option to do split screen and it would look something like this. It makes a lot of sense. We've seen it on other operating systems. We've even seen it on iPad with split screen. So we have that option there. They could just call it split view and we'll see that hopefully on iOS 15. This has been rumored for a long time, so we may not actually see it, but hopefully we will. Now, the next thing a lot of people want to see is a redesigned lock screen. So what that would mean is maybe some better notifications like this, where you would have your notifications along the top, maybe of your different apps, maybe your calendar widget, your weather widget, whatever you would like, you would be able to customize. This makes a lot of sense, and a lot of people want to see this along with what could be an always-on display, maybe on new phones, like you get with the Apple Watch. When you kind of tilt it down, it goes into sort of a sleep 1 hertz mode where it leaves the display on all the time, but doesn't really use much battery at all. So that would be really nice if they can vary the refresh rate on the display, although this might be reserved for something like an iPhone 13, for example. So that seems to make a lot of sense. Now, many of you have wanted interactive widgets since Apple launched widgets with iOS 14. The widgets are really helpful, but the problem with them is they're not in real time. So for example, this weather widget, if I tap on it, it's showing that it's 72 degrees Fahrenheit where I live. The widget's showing 71. The widget updates based on when the developer says to update to try and save some battery. We would love to see interactive widgets, whether that be with music or maybe reminders, where you could just interact right here without going into the app. Maybe we'll see that with iOS 15. Also, many of you have talked about revamping the contacts app or the phone app. So a combination of the two. A lot of people want to see, well, an unlimited call log. So when you go into there and you have a call log. A lot of people want to have it unlimited. Currently, it's limited to about 100 calls, and then it starts deleting the ones at the end. So the people want to see an unlimited call log, as well as maybe a screening feature like the Google Pixel has, where it screens the call for you, responds with AI, and then gives you that information via a text pop-up message. So that's something I would love to see. It's one thing I love about the Pixel that I wish they'd bring to iPhone. Also, people would like to see call recording just like we have screen recording. Now, I don't personally think we're going to see that since that's more of a privacy concern and it varies from state to state in the United States, for example, and country to country. So that's something that they may not ever go near, but a lot of people want the ability to not only record your screen, but also record calls. Of course, you would have to have a way to notify that person that their call would be recorded. So it's something that I think a lot of people would appreciate, but I don't know that Apple would ever add. And probably the number one thing people want to see with contacts is an update to the contacts app where you start searching by a phone number or something else, and it would predict who you're wanting to talk to. So this is a great idea for a redesigned call app or maybe contacts app. You start typing in an area code and it shows you all of those people in an area code. This is something that's been on other contact apps for a long time, and I think it's time to bring it to iOS as well. So that's what most people want to see. There were a couple mentions of people wanting better dual SIM support, meaning you could better send a message to someone already in a contact without having to start a new conversation to send a different message from a different number. So if you're using dual SIMs, I don't have that personally in the United States. It's not really a thing here, but if you're overseas and you have that, it could be very helpful for those who use it. So I actually don't have it, so I can't show you what it's like, but it's something I think would be valuable to a lot of people. Now, something a lot of people would like to see is an overhaul of notifications. Now, I find this only seems to be true to those people that actually come from Android. So if you're on iOS, a lot of people don't mind the notification system. They would just like more customization. And that's something that many people are saying will come with iOS 15. So you would be able to go into your settings, maybe go to notifications and maybe better customize those notifications. So not just what we have now, but maybe different alerts and all sorts of things. So it would be great to see updates to this. I believe we will see it, such as different colors for badges, more customization, or even a good suggestion was if you're being spammed with a notification in your messages, for example, you would be able to set a limit so that it would silence it, something along those lines. I thought that was a great idea. Now, a lot of people want to see a redesigned control center. I like this one. I've shown this before. It matches basically what we have on macOS. And if it matches across iOS, macOS, and iPadOS, I think that makes a lot of sense. I don't know that it needs to change dramatically, but an update or a refresh to sort of match what we have already for consistency's sake makes a lot of sense. Also, some have said they'd like to see auto brightness within the control center, as well as maybe better access to your Wi-Fi settings. So instead of pressing and holding and going in, you would just be able to get a little bit better Wi-Fi settings to truly turn it off here, instead of having to go into settings, for example. We used to be able to do that with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. You can't do it as easily anymore. A lot of people would like to see that brought back. Now, something I hear continuously from a lot of people has to do with apps, and a lot of people would like the ability to lock an individual app with Face ID or Touch ID. So maybe you could press on the camera, for example, and it would lock that individual app. So that's something a lot of people have wanted to see. Also, people want to see updated settings. Now, this is another thing that's rumored to change with iOS 15, and an updated settings page, whether it looks like this concept or not, could be welcome, where it gives you your storage here, what version you're on, and then just different information, where you could delete your apps individually from here. It would be searchable, and I know a lot of people would appreciate that. Other suggestions are maybe a work mode in settings or a time off mode. So when you're home, it switches to email that you care about or things like that. I think that makes a lot of sense. It's a nice way to manage a phone where it's got a work mode and a home mode, for example. Also, one thing I heard a lot from people is pro camera settings in the app. So the app has the ability to have some settings in here, but there's not a whole lot of pro settings within the camera app. You do have some if you tap on this button, but you don't have things such as white balance necessarily or ISO where you can customize those. You can do that with third-party apps. A lot of people want to see that brought to the iPhone in the standard app. I personally would love to see settings within the camera app where you don't have to go back and forth, for example, to the settings within the settings app. So you would be able to manage most of your settings here They did bring resolution last year where we can change the video resolution, but that's about it. So we can change the resolution from 4K 30 to 24 to 60, but we don't have the option to switch between HDR here, for example, or turn that on or off. You have to go to the settings app to do that. I would love to see those brought here. It makes a lot of sense, and a redesign of this makes a lot of sense as well. Now, another thing I do like the idea of that people mentioned, and that is if we go into maybe a FaceTime call, we could share our screen. A lot of people want to see what you're doing. You can kind of do this on a Mac. You used to be able to do things a little bit easier with iChat. Now you can do it on a Mac with different apps and things, but to see it natively within FaceTime makes a lot of sense, especially on an iPhone. So you could share your different FaceTime call. You could share your screen along the side, and you can see what this could look like, and you have plenty of room to do that. So the newer processors are plenty fast. I think they could handle this, and I think it would be welcome if they had that. It'd be great to be able to show people how to do things live. Now, other people mentioned a few small things, and then I'll talk about iPadOS in a moment. Now, a few other people said they'd like to see keyboard accuracy and predictions improved. So whether or not you're in iMessage, maybe you're typing hello, and the keyboard sometimes isn't accurate, or sometimes the suggestions are way off. So some people would like to see that improved, along with maybe the ability to remove or recall messages within messages. So those are some things people mentioned, and also being able to put folders in the dock of the iPhone itself or the iPad. So being able to put a folder in the dock, have that easily moved there, makes a lot of sense. And then finally, people have said photos. We'd like to see photos have family sharing of the entire photo album, not just albums you select, as well as maybe better organization. You can sort of organize it right now, but better organization makes sense. Also user accounts as well. So you'd be able to switch between different users. I think that's more likely on an iPad though, instead of on an iPhone. So if we switch over to the iPad, on the iPad, having multiple accounts like this makes a lot of sense, being able to switch between people since a lot of people share their iPads. Also, having maybe a different lock screen makes sense as well. So better widgets, better notifications, things like that. And then of course, I think something we're going to see is a redesigned home screen. And this could sort of be what it looks like. It may look a little bit different, but being able to put your widgets everywhere is what's expected in the next version of iPadOS. So this looks like something we may get. It may look completely different than this, but being able to move everything around makes a lot of sense, where you could just kind of move your widgets wherever you'd want, have a whole screen full of widgets and more. And also redesigned icons, maybe matching that of Big Sur or maybe a whole new aesthetic that Apple would do. So a lot of people want to see that. With the iPad, some people have mentioned that they'd like to see better mouse support. So instead of just having that circle, you would have maybe a mouse cursor, for example, real monitor support where it would work on maybe a Pro Display XDR or just any monitor and be the actual aspect ratio instead of just mirroring this display, having multiple monitor support, and then being able to do things like have multiple videos playing at once, allow a low power mode in the control center, battery health in the iPad, and bedtime mode for the iPad. Those are the most wanted requests for the iPad. I didn't want to cover the iPad 100% since as we get closer to iPadOS 15, I'm sure we'll see more and more of what's coming soon. Now, there were a couple other things worth mentioning that people had some good ideas about, and those have to do with screen time. So for example, screen time, you may be able to exclude certain apps. That's what people wanted to see. And then also maybe you're setting an alarm. If you go into the clock, setting an alarm, tapping multiple times can be a pain. So maybe just an easy way to go in and set an alarm. So let's go back here. We'll go to this one. We'll go to edit, tap this one, and then tap in here. And then you can edit one at a time or you can scroll. So doing that can be a bit of a pain. I'd like to see them change that again, since it's not as nice as it was before. And then more people want to see you to be able to set more default apps, such as music, for example. So based on what you had to say, that's what you wanted to see most in iOS 15. Hopefully we get some of those, such as split screen or split view, as Apple calls it, maybe different accounts, a slight redesign of the control center is rumored. So hopefully we get at least some of those things. I do think we will get some redesigned apps as well. Let me know what you want to see most though in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.